And my Early Star co-anchor, Zoraida Samblin, who's here with us, who has a unique perspective on all this morning and the decisions that Angelina Jolie has made and the challenges she faces.
You know what, I said that I really struggled. You know, for a while I've been struggling because I was diagnosed with breast cancer about 3 weeks ago, and I was trying to figure out, how do I share this story? How do I tell the viewers that I'm going to be gone for a while because I've chosen to have a double mastectomy? And so Angelina Jolie's story really hit home. I do not have the BRCA gene. I don't know if I have the BRCA gene, I should say. I have chosen to have genetic testing, not because it runs in my family, but because at the end of the day, I have a lot of girls in my family. And I figure it starts somewhere. And Elizabeth Cohen is absolutely right. It's a genetic counselor that you sit with and that goes over this entire history with you so that you can make this major decision as to whether or not you even want to do this. But it's an expensive test. And one of the things that Angelina Jolie, if Elizabeth is still there, one of the things that she talked about is it's an incredibly expensive test and it's not always paid for by an insurance company. So what is the option for women if, in fact, it doesn't get paid for by an insurance company, if you know that you do carry this gene, Elizabeth?
Right. One of the options is that you can apply to the company that makes the gene and ask them for help. And they have helped many, many women, you know, sometimes giving it for free or giving subsidies to, so that they can get it. What's interesting is that the Supreme Court is now looking at this because one of the reasons this price is so high is only one company is allowed to make it because they have the patent on the breast cancer gene. If the Supreme Court this spring says, guess what, guys, you don't have the patent anymore, that price may come down because with competition, as we all know, prices come down. But, you know, ask Myriad, will you help me pay for this? And there are also various foundations that will help women pay for this if they need it. If they've got breast cancer or ovarian cancer in their family, there is help out there for getting this test paid for.
No, absolutely. And the other big thing is that when you do choose to have a double mastectomy, first of all, you can make that choice as a woman. You can decide, this is what I want to do in order to manage my care. And the insurance company does pay for the reconstruction. And I cannot emphasize that enough because there are so many women that I've talked to that had no idea that an insurance company actually pays for that. It's a big process. It's long. It's daunting. Angelina's talked about it, 3 months of this long process in order to get to the other side. But an insurance company will also cover that cost.
She says it's an empowering decision in a way.
You know what it is? It is, because you can make that decision as a woman. One of the things that she talks about that is very emotional for me because, you know, as a woman, your sexuality and your breasts and how attached you are to that, right, as a woman. And so at the end of the day, it's really difficult to say that I'm thinking about this, that this is something that affects me when I have two kids that, you know, I want to live for, and that at the end of the day, I'm gonna cut off my arms if it means that I am going to live to see them and to see them grow up. That's my boy, Nico, who, by the way, has handled this incredibly well and will be there with me for the surgery. But it is a tough decision to make, to say, because, you know, this is a crazy thing, but I did a Google search, breasts after mastectomy. And the computer could not compute what I was asking because you don't have breasts anymore after a mastectomy, right, Elizabeth? So it was really tough because I just wanted to know, well, what's that process like? And it couldn't put those two together.
Right, that's interesting. You do have breasts after mastectomy. You don't have the breasts.
The tissue.
Right.
It's gone,
but you
yeah.
have reconstructed breasts.
Yeah.
And I actually was with a woman as she was coming out of the operating room after she had her reconstructive surgery. And she talked about, after she, you know, sort of came to, how glad she was that she'd done it and how relieved she felt that these breasts that had become cancerous were gone and that she had reconstructed breasts. So I think it's so brave, Zoraida, that you're talking about this, because so many women will have to go through this, making the decision once they've been diagnosed, which is your situation, or trying to make a decision if they carry the BRCA gene, if they carry the breast cancer gene. These are tough decisions in both cases, and it's so wonderful that you're talking about this, because it shows you're a smart woman, you're proactive, you're empowered, and you went about this in the exact right way.
Well, you know, I have to say, I watched that story that you're talking about. My first phone call when I was diagnosed was to my fiance, who has been nothing but an amazing supporter during all of this. The second one was to Ronnie Seelig, who you know is your producer there in the medical unit. She was my second phone call, a strong woman who knew exactly who I needed to go to call in order to get through this. My biggest worry was how do I tell my kids, and how do I walk them through that process? My son handled this incredibly well. There he is again. I asked him, I said, you know, when you think of breast cancer, when somebody says that to you, what and that's my little girl there on the left-hand side, that's Sophia. What do you think about? And he said, I think about a fight. And I thought, thank goodness, because that'll make this conversation a lot easier. For my daughter, she's only 9 years old, and it was actually a much simpler conversation than I originally thought it was going to be, because, you know, I asked her, what do you think about when you hear breast cancer? And she said, I think about people's hair falling out, and I think about them being sick. And I said, well, my hair's not going to fall out, and I'm not going to get sick. And then she said to me, why did you want that picture of me that you asked me for to send you? And I thought, great, we've moved on, you know? So that fear that women are going to have about talking to their kids, there are ways to do that. There are ways to be empowered also. And I cannot say enough, Elizabeth, that our own website, I have an incredible family here at CNN who is totally supportive, and there's so much information on our website for women who are struggling with this. And surround yourself with women, because at the end of the day, they're the ones who are going to help you get through this as well. Great men also. I'm going to give kudos to John Berman because he's been incredibly supportive. But the women here, really, you know, they can walk you through this process like nobody else can.
You know, Elizabeth, Zoraida, what you're saying is so important, because it's important, whatever diagnosis it is, to know someone else has been in your been in your place before you. Someone else has gone through this before you. Get in touch with them. They may be across the country, but get in touch with them, because they can give you so much wisdom. I can't even tell you how many patients have told me, I made the right decision because I talked to someone who had been in my shoes before I was in my shoes.
Well, we started this talking about Angelina Jolie. She has Brad Pitt with her. You've got your own family, which is good or better than Brad Pitt. You have
you
all of us here.
You are not alone, is all I have to say.
All of us here right by your side, with you very much leading the way. So, Zoraida Samblin, thanks to you. Elizabeth Cohen, our thanks to you.